What if your AI assistant could run an entire project task by task without ever losing context? Now I know, my last video covered frameworks that promise the same thing. But Taskmaster AI, the tool we are looking at today, has a specific architectural advantage that actually solves the context decay problem. It configures its own MCP server that feeds the AI agent only the focused data it needs to complete a task. It's a complete game changer for how the AI interacts with your project's state. My last video on AI methodologies got a ton of attention. Taskmaster was brought a few times in the comments, and it was definitely worth checking out. I had some long overdue work on a pet project, so I gave it a real-world test. For this video, I'll be using it with Claude Code Opus for planning and Sonnet 4.5 for implementation. This is a mix of a tutorial and a live demo. I'm going to show you how I set it up, the commands I ran, the problems I hit, and the final results. Let's get into it. First, the project. This is an Astro website filled with tutorials on React libraries, all written by our two fictional personas, the gray cat and the orange cat. The problem is the article count grew to over 500. And when that happened, the build times became painfully long. It just wasn't sustainable. I decided it was time to migrate the whole thing off of MDX files and onto a proper database. I chose Astro DB, which is a relatively new and exciting development in the Astro ecosystem. It's backed by Terso, which has a generous free tier, so it was an easy choice. This migration is the perfect complex multi-step project to test Taskmaster. Let's start with the tutorial part, getting Taskmaster set up. First, the installation. It's a global CLI tool. Once it's installed, you CD into your project and run Taskmaster in it. This kicks off an interactive setup. You'll answer a few questions like whether you want to use Git for tasks. But here is the most critical step for folks like me. When it asks for your model provider, if you're using a Claude Pro subscription, you must select the Claude Code provider. I was confused at first and almost picked Anthropic, but the Anthropic provider expects an API key, which is separate pay-per-use product. The Claude Code provider is the one that hooks into your existing subscription through the CLI, no API key required. This was a major point of confusion for me, and I'll come back to it. Next, you need a product requirement document or PRD. This is just a text or markdown file where you brain dump your project goals. I ask Claude to generate one for me based on my migration plan. You then save this file in the Taskmaster docs directory. With the PRD in place, you run the first magic command, Taskmaster parse PRD. This is where Taskmaster shines. It sends that PRD to your main LLM and tells it to decompose the entire project into a structured list of tasks. This plan is saved in a tasks.json file. This JSON file becomes the external brain for your project. It includes titles, details, test strategies, and most importantly, dependencies. This creates a dependency graph, which means Taskmaster knows you can't implement the search API before you migrated the data. This structure also allows for parallel work. You can have two or more tasks being worked on at the same time as long as they don't have conflicting dependencies. Now, you might be wondering, how does my AI chat know about these CLI commands? Taskmaster uses a different approach. It's not using the built-in slash commands within the Claude Code CLI. Instead, it registers itself as a model context protocol or MCP server. It actually appends your existing claude.md file or creates one with an import of its own documentation. This makes Claude aware of all the Taskmaster commands and MCP tools, which is why you can just chat in natural language, saying implement the next task, and Claude knows exactly what to call. It's also provider agnostic. It supports tons of LLMs. If you have multiple subscriptions, you can easily configure a powerful model like Opus for research and a faster, cheaper one like Sonnet for implementation. So that's the setup. What's the actual day-to-day workflow like? Once my task.json was generated, my first real step was to get more detail on the first task. For this, you use the expand command, taskmaster expand --id=1. This takes the high-level task like setup Astro DB with Torso integration and breaks it down into 5 granular subtasks, storing them right back in the tasks.json file. You can also add a research flag to use your potentially more powerful research model for this step. With the task expanded, you just ask the AI to get to work. I'd type, okay, let's implement task 1. The AI would then read the task and its new subtasks, mark the main task as in progress, start implementing the first subtask. As it completes each subtask, it updates its status, giving you a clear progress bar. Once all subtasks are done, it marks the parent task as complete. You don't even have to specify the ID, you can just say work on the next task. Internally, the AI runs taskmaster next, which checks the dependency graph and task priorities to find the most logical next step. If you hit a point where the plan needs to change, you can use taskmaster update to give it a new prompt and course correct. And for tasks that need fresh info, the taskmaster research command will use your research model to browse the web before starting. So, how did it go on my real-world project? Honestly, shockingly well. I basically just followed the AI's instructions. It guided me through the entire migration. It handed all the Astro DB CLI commands, created the database, generated the new schemas, and wrote the migration scripts to pull all data from my old MDX files. When it came time to deploy, it even told me which environment variables to set in the Netlify UI. The bigger tasks like rewriting all data fetching logic didn't work perfectly on the first try. But after a few short, reasonable back and forths, we got there. When I finally saw my production database populated with all 571 articles, tags, and authors, I mean, it was absolutely stunning work. I migrated my entire website to a new database architecture faster than I ever thought possible. But it wasn't perfect. I hit 2 major hiccups. The first was a showstopper. After implementing the first couple of tasks, the taskmaster expand command just stopped working. I'd run it and it would fail with a vague error. Cloud code API error during object generation. Cloud code process exited with code 1. My workaround was to go back to manual prompting, asking Cloud to please read the task JSON and generate subtasks for task 3, following the format of the other tasks. It worked, but it was clunky. The next day, I was stumped. I finally just fed the whole problem to Cloud. After investigating, it figured it out and told me that the problem must be that I had placeholder API keys in my .env file. It made no sense. But I deleted them and the expand command started working instantly. My guess is that Taskmaster saw any API key variable in their environment and tried to use that provider first. Since the key was invalid, it would fail before it even got the chance to try the correct Cloud Code provider. The key takeaway: keep your env file clean of any placeholder API keys. The second hiccup was 100% my fault, but it was a tricky one. A few days later, it broke again with the exact same error message. This time I realized I had switched my Node.js version using NVM and had forgotten to globally reinstall the Cloud Code CLI. So Taskmaster was trying to call a command that did not exist. So after all that, what are my professional takeaways on Taskmaster AI? First, it's a fantastic and solid alternative to other methodologies. And second, it actually solves the context decay, but not just with the tasks.json file. The real magic is the MCP approach. The AI doesn't load all 500 of your tasks into its context window. It uses an MCP tool to query the tasks.json file, like taskmaster show 1, and only gets back the relevant information for that single task. This is how it maintains state on massive projects without polluting its context. Of course, a couple of rules are universal no matter what tool you use. The quality of your project is always directly proportional to the quality of your initial PRD, and your role definitely shifts from prompt engineer to agent orchestrator. You're guiding a plan, not just asking for code. I was also impressed that this tool is actively developed, seemingly by individual developers without huge corporate backing. The community on GitHub is active and pull requests are flying. That's a great sign. Overall, it's a solid choice. And remember, these methodologies are not lifetime commitments. Switching is easy. You can remove one tools folder and install another in an afternoon. The important part is finding the workflow that works for you. What do you think? Have you tried Taskmaster? And what's your favorite AI development methodology for this week? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and don't forget to feed your cat.